Okay, guys, we're about to go grocery shopping. And we are about to use our EBT, Eat Better Tonight. We're literally about to plant like 20, 30 different plants that we're about to pick up that we can literally start our garden today. You can use your EBT to purchase whatever groceries you need to start your garden at home, right? So let's go ahead, let's head to the store. I'm gonna go to the grocery store. I'm gonna show you guys everything that you can get out of the grocery store to start your at-home garden. So we're gonna replant, we're gonna regrow, and we're gonna start some stuff from seeds. I'm gonna show you which stores that you can actually get seeds from and start. I'm gonna show you which stores that you can actually get the actual fruit and vegetable to start your garden from as well. So let's dive in. We got about 30 to 40 different plants that we can start off of our EBT. Yay! Okay. Let's dive in. Okay, we are here at the store. I'm gonna do the fresh market because I wanna get some organic and super fresh veggies. So this is one of my stores I would go to. So let's go right on in there. We are here, we got the veggies. So, and we're gonna be able to like literally get a lot of stuff. So one thing we can do is definitely garlic. So we can definitely regrow the garlic. There we go.
Help me.
And we've got lettuces that we can regrow, literally all the lettuce, all the parsley, green onions, carrots. We will pass the collard, celery, yes. We got bok choys and cabbages for sure. Okay, now I'm gonna show you some of the other ones, like the roots and like the potatoes and stuff, right? Okay, so we got turmeric, you know, we got ginger that we can add. And then we got potatoes, we got onion. We got sweet potatoes that we can regrow. All of these. Even the shallot. So we about to get to it. Oh, and I can't forget regrowing. Dun, dun, dun. Pineapples. Yes, guys, that's right. We are totally going to regrow some pineapples. And I'm going to go ahead and get an aloe vera. Okay, so we have all of our groceries inside. And we want to talk about what we did. So here we have it. Now we are in Kroger, or you know, some other people would call it like a Sprouse. So yeah, they got the living herbs, and it's organic living herbs. It's perfect. So we have some thyme here. They got some cilantro. I already have some dimes. So I'm gonna actually just go ahead and get some cilantro. And then it has some mint too. Mint. Peppermint soup. Okay. So already ready to go.
$4
Okay, go ahead.
So now it is time to fill it. So yum. Fam, social media, IG, Facebook fam, everybody, hey. So today's pretty cool. Today is a really cool day for me and for you and for anyone else following, because today we're gonna talk about how to start your garden with EBT. That's right. Good old eat better tonight. That's right. You know, we used to grow it. We used to talk about people because they had food stamps. So, I mean, I know back in the day, you know, it was kind of a sign of you're not doing well, so you take free food, you know. But at the end of the day, like, thank God that it's available and it's there for us, right? So I think we have spent time talking about people, making people feel bad about it, but let's look at the blessing behind it, right? Because if you didn't have food, then you would be like really in a bad place, right? So having our, you know, government that provides that is a blessing. And so I know a lot of times people tend to think and say a lot of nasty things about our government and things like that. And I agree, there's a lot of things that could be changed and be much better. Absolutely. But I think we have to absolutely appreciate the fact that we have a situation and a type of system that can provide you free food, right? And it might not be a lot, it might not be enough, maybe it might be enough, maybe it might be too much for some folks. But per se, the fact that we're able to get free food in the midst of our different trials, tribulations, journeys, anything can happen. You can lose your job in a moment, and then you need something to help you out while you get back on your feet, while you get going into the next phase or whatever of your life. It doesn't matter. This thing that they have created is a blessing. And for so many people who were affected by COVID and went through a huge deficit of that, then this is a blessing for you and your family, you and your six kids, you and, you know what I mean? Like, this is a blessing, so we have to be grateful for our blessing. Now, while we have this blessing and before our blessing runs out or runs its course, let's do some cool things that can help sustain us overall for a lifetime, right? So I decided to share and show you guys what all you can buy to start your garden off of EBT. Yes. So a lot of people think that, you know, I have EBT, I can't do anything with it. But no, let me tell you, outside of the fact that you can buy your favorite Cheerios and your favorite lactose-free milk or organic products, or, you know, your Cheetos, you know, your yogurt, whatever you can get, you can actually buy vegetables that you can regrow and then plant them in your garden. And so you'll be surprised, because there's quite a bit of things that you can start and regrow on your own just from the grocery store that you don't have to use from seed, and start to regenerate them and get them to start shooting out some roots, and then you can just plant it into the soil. And there's also a nice amount of veggies and herbs that they have that are already ready to go. And as long as it's a food, then it is considered an item that can be purchased with your EBT, as long as it is a food that you can digest. If it is growing and you can eat it, guess what? You can purchase it with your food stamps. I mean, well, I'm sorry, not with your EBT card. You'll eat better tonight. Exactly. So there's some plants that are already ready to go that are that literally are just transplants that you can purchase, which is really great. Then there's the ones that you have to actually put them in water and to regrow them over some time. And then you can plant them outside, I mean, or in your garden, wherever you choose, indoor, outdoors. And then also, you can purchase seeds with your EBT card. And if you don't believe me, watch the rest of this video, because you will see me doing it and purchasing it and showing you that there's all the receipts, it's EBT, so you know for sure it's real. So, first thing, you know, yes. So, okay, yeah, so we have that. We have, you know, your seeds that you can purchase. And then I want to give you a list of stores that you can purchase these items from. So, first things first. Lowe's and Home Depot and Ace and any other nursery store has not approved allowing you to use your EBT card in their store to purchase items. So that is a little bit of the unfortunate side, because I love Lowe's and Home Depot to get my great transplants, and it would be, I mean, phenomenal, you know, if you could be able to take your EBT and purchase those plants as well. That would be just the highlight to this. But there are other nurseries that will allow you to purchase it from them. I believe there's only one, though, as of right now, that has been given the government green light approval to allow you to purchase different seeds and stuff from them. But one place that is allowing you to purchase seeds from them, like right now, is Amazon. Woo, 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 woo for Amazon. Amazon is awesome. Amazon has it where you can actually purchase, they do have a few transplants. It's not many that I saw, maybe about 3 or 4. But hey, something's better than nothing, right? So you can purchase a few transplants, and then they have where you can purchase some seeds. They don't have a lot of options and a lot of variety, like you would say your Lowe's or your Home Depot and things like that. They don't have a lot of variety yet, but they do have options. And I, again, something is better than nothing. And so I would suggest to get everything that you can get with your EBT, and then whatever else that you can't, then you just purchase it outright on your own. But this is a start, and you can definitely get about 60 to 70 plants or whatever going, right? But one store that you can go and purchase your seeds right now and get pretty much any type of vegetable is your local Dollar Tree. And if you don't have a Dollar Tree, then your local 99 cent store. Yes, that's right, guys. The 99 cent store has seeds. Dollar Tree, yes, has seeds. So Now, these seeds, I'm not 100% sure if they are organic. So that's where it gets a little bit. But I do know that a lot of plants, I mean, that are hybrids or mixed with GMOs usually tend to not procreate. Tend to not like actually put out a seed that you can regrow, usually. So I would assume that these seeds are pretty decent. I have actually got some seeds from 99-cent store and Dollar Tree and have used them. I've planted them and I think I actually, did some mustard greens and they were actually quite phenomenal, the greens. That was the only thing that I have used so far. I've done some parsley actually and some arugula, but that was it that I've used from the seeds. I've just kind of just been storing them per se for a rainy day. So I've just been storing my seeds per se. So I have not been using my seeds. But so far what I've used has been pretty good. So I would have to say it's good to go. So again, you can get all kinds of stuff from the 99-cent store and Dollar Tree, okay? To just get your garden girl going. Now it's gonna be some real cheap stuff, man. It ain't gonna be the quality. So it might last you a couple months, maybe two or three, but you can get some stuff there, right? But for sure, get your seeds. Cause they're like, I went to Dollar Tree and they were $4, which is pretty great. So that's 25 cents. I think I spent $3 and I got 15 different plants. 12. But yes, we got 12 different plants. Now I got some flowers in there like marigold because we want those in the garden so that they can attract all of those good yummy little cute bees so that they can be able to fertilize our good old flowers and give us our fruits and vegetables. So, oh, some green beans. But yeah, so you know, I particularly, the Dollar Tree that I went to was kind of cleaned out. Saw that, they were like, and let me get everything. So they pretty much almost cleaned out those seeds. So I would highly suggest if you're gonna go get seeds, go get them now because springtime is approaching and people are literally getting ready to start planting and growing and get it pop locking and dropping, okay? So definitely go get your seeds now, okay? And and this is on the EBT, you know what I'm saying? If y'all don't want to do the EBT, y'all can always go to modelsgarden.com and get your organic, natural, very good quality seeds, okay? So, you know, I got the good juice too now, you know? But if you wanted to go ahead and still make it happen and make it do what it do, because let me tell you, beggars can't be choosy. And whenever it gets real rough, it don't matter what the heck you got now, as long as it do what it do. So, these are great. Have them. Even if it's a backup plan. If it's a backup, if all else fails, you have these. It's better than nothing again. It's better than nothing. So, so just to give you guys a quick look at what we got. We got some peas, right? We got some daisies, you know, I want to put some flowers, at least I'm going to want to look at, right, in there. Green beans, yellow green beans. I've never had these, I've never done these, but I'm going to try them. I'm actually going to plant them just to see what they do, because I've never had yellow green beans. Green beans, did I even call it green beans? Because if it's not green, it's yellow beans. That's a good one. Would it be yellow beans or green beans? I don't know. They call it the Cherokee yellow bush. All right. Yellow beans. Parsley. Cauliflower. Squash. It's a winter squash. Some more flowers. Summer squash. The marigolds. Marigolds are great. They work phenomenal. Fine. I just feel like a bee. I need something right now. Lettuce. And then the green beans. Literally, green beans. Okay, so yes. So that is what we can purchase, and we can get so many more. You know, I know I've gotten radishes, peas, green beans, squash, watermelon. I found all kinds of stuff at Dollar Tree and in my nice and store. You name it, they have it. Peppers, bell peppers, chili peppers, jalapenos, chives, arugula, oregano, they got it, okay? So just go ahead and dive in there and get whatever seeds you need. EBT, free of charge. Okay, so let's dive into some of these vegetables. I'm gonna zoom in. I'm gonna actually show you guys cutting them and planting them into the garden and just go through this whole process, okay? So here we have 12 for sure plants that we can put, right? Okay, so let's go down the list of things that I actually bought from the grocery store. And I have them all here on the table. Let's see, you know, I'm a one-man army here, so please bear with me with my whole little spiel here, okay? But, so these are the options that we have. So we have good old garlic that we can regrow. We're gonna put these things, all these items here, we're gonna put them in water, and we're going to regrow them over the next few days and weeks, and then to have them transplanted outside into our garden. So right now we have our garlic, okay? We got onion. That's right, we're gonna regrow all this stuff. We got sweet potatoes. We're going to regrow this, okay? We got some avocado for y'all avocado lovers. I can't eat avocados, but for those that can, woo-hoo, turn it up. Okay, we got cilantro. We have lettuce. You can do any lettuce. This particularly is a green leaf lettuce that I got. You can do romaine lettuce. You can do red leaf lettuce. Whatever lettuce that strikes your thing that you love, that's your favorite, you go ahead and you plant that. Because that's, like my Tabitha would say, that's your business. I love Tabitha. She's so cute. Okay. So, here we go. We got some curly parsley. You can do curly. You can do it flat Italian parsley. Whatever parsley you want to do, you just grab it and you make it do what it's doing. Okay? We got some ginger. Woo-hoo. Yes, y'all. We can regrow ginger from the store. We got some potatoes. Potatoes. I like to do these little baby potatoes personally for me because I'm not a big like baked potato person or anything else like that, but I can mash these and make mashed potatoes. I can bake these and make roasted potatoes. You know, I can even cut them up and put them for breakfast or whatever. So, and I love the medleys and things like that. So, you know, you can get some of every kind. So what you could do with this is you could separate your yellows, your purples, and your reds and just plant them by themselves, and then, you know, your whole batch is all gonna be one. Or you can mix them together and then just get a variety that comes out swell as well. But these do great. And you can do regular russet potatoes, you can do gold potatoes, Yukon potatoes, whatever potato that you like, it is the same process that takes place. And I will discuss those processes soon. But we got some potatoes, okay? We got some cabbage. And I choose organic, you know, I do organic everything. So, you know, I wanna make sure it's good quality of plants that are gonna be planted and eventually seeds that I can grab. Okay, shallots, that's right. You can go ahead and regrow shallots for those that love shallots. I love a salad. We got turmeric, yep, that's right. Y'all can regrow some turmeric. And y'all know turmeric got all the health benefits, right? So, what is this? Ooh, is this aloe vera? Yes, you can regrow aloe vera. Okay, and let's see what else we got. Ooh, carrots. Looks like carrots. We can regrow us some carrots. Where the working man does and green onion. Woo-hoo. Green onion. You can regrow us some green onions. And as you can see, the roots are already there, ready to go. So these are going to be the easiest thing of them all. And last but not least, out of the regrow collection, celery. That's right. You're like, can I really regrow this? Yep. Yes, you can. Boom, boom, and it will look and turn into this. That's right, all of this. So, okay, so those are our beautiful regrow plants that we will literally regrow in water. Now, these are the plants that we can get from actual transplants. Oh, excuse me. Let me not forget Mrs. Pineapple over here. Aha. Yes, guys, we can regrow pineapple. I'm so excited about this because I love me some pineapple, and the fact of knowing that I can regrow this is just awesome. Awesome. All we gotta do is take this thing right here and use that to regrow it. And as you can see, it's extremely yellow because it is very good to make sure you get the ripest pineapple possible so that it is already starting to shoot out its roots that are within here. And I will definitely dive into explaining more about that. But right in here is the roots, and you're just gonna pull this thing off. But the more yellow, the more ripe it is, and the more better it is, and the more better you'll take in the water for you guys. So that is the pineapple. And yes, so let's go back into these ghetto. Okay, so let's go into the ones that can be transplants. So mint is one of those. I love a good mint, especially in the summer. It is just like so refreshing, you know. If you want like a good mojito, you gotta throw some mint up in there. Throw some mint on that. Or even if you just like to have some cool, like I make these amazing watermelon bites with mint and feta cheese, and it is just so refreshing for the summer. I love it. So having mint is just great. And then of course, making some good old mint tea. Can't go wrong with that. You know, so you can have mint, got peppermint and spearmint. Okay. But we mint ready, and you can do a whole lot of healing with mint as well. I'm pretty sure some of you guys know, some of you guys don't know, but mint has a lot of healing remedies. So you can't go wrong with mint, right? And it's literally ready to go in its cute little thing here. I'm gonna like pop it up so you can see. But it is fully ready to go. All you do is just pop it out, boom. And you just place that right in your soil. Ready to go. Look at that. Look at that. Save yourself some time. And it's already growing, so you don't have to worry about, is it gonna grow or not? It's growing, baby, it's growing. So that definitely can start you guys off at a faster pace. If you're like, oh my God, it's gonna take me months. Relax, we can grow some things right now. It's okay, don't worry. Okay, here we have it. This is our vine. Ooh, this baby bushy, okay. I don't know about y'all, but when I smell fine, I start thinking about oxtails and Jamaican food. Okay. Y'all know I'm working on my pescatarian side, so I mean, I really have not had an oxtail. Oh my God, I feel like I haven't had an oxtail in like a year. Mm-hmm. Oh, when the Lord changes you, he doesn't remember on you, you know, and food is one of those options, and you can't have oxygen because we're not eating blood. We're eating food from mud. Not food from blood, food from mud. Okay, moving on. But that's a nice one. This is actually a really good one. Because usually they're smaller, but I really came up, okay? Look at how big this is. I did that. I'm trying to think, where did I get this one at? I think I got that one. Well, the liquid fire filled his lungs and his eyes silenced. Publix. I was like trying to remember, I went to so many stores. Yes, Publix. So, there you have it. Okay, so here we go. This is rosemary. You know, for those rosemary potatoes, that good old rosemary chicken, baked chicken. But again, I can't do the rosemary. Fake chicken. So I just do the rosemary potatoes and everything else that I could do rosemary in. And then I also like to put the rosemary in my sauna, you know, my steamer and everything, you know, when I'm trying to take my good old detox and stuff, steam and sauna. The rosemary is amazing and smells so wonderful and so vibrant. So, and then also is really good for your hair and things like that, which is part of the hair products that I have, which is rosemary. And that good old aloe vera shampoo and conditioner. Don't play. Pat your hair down your back, baby. Okay? And then cilantro. So there's so many more, but these are the ones that I was able to find, particularly on my shopping shop that I just did recently. I wanted to make sure everything was done in the same day and fresh and not separated in days apart, because then like that wouldn't necessarily be helpful for getting this out right away. So yeah, so anyway, so we have cilantro and it's all ready to go. So you can get cilantro, you can also get oregano, parsley. I'm trying to think of what other things I've seen. Basil, I think I've seen chives. Excuse me, I've seen chives. But there's quite a bit that you can find in your local grocery store, literally. Now, I will say, and I have it founded on this experience, this excursion that I went on to create this video, but, but I have found that at Kroger's and Ralph's, yes, Kroger's and Ralph's, they will have some like transplants outside, right? So if you can see a transplant outside, even if you go to Sprouts too, as well, Sprouts sometimes has plants outside, right? So if you go to one of those places and you see that there are plants outside of your grocery store and it is edible, it is a food, you can absolutely purchase it with your EBT. So if you go to the store and you go and you look in whatever and they got some stuff out at Kroger's and they got some cucumbers or some watermelons, pick them up, because you can, and they're transplants, they'll have them, they'll be looking just like this, but you know, the ones inside got this cool cute plastic on. But the ones outside literally are just like this. They're just like this. They might have a little stake in it that tells you what the name of the plant is, but they'll be outside and they'll be like this. Don't pass that stuff by. Don't be like, oh my God, it's $12 of your EBT, not of your cash. So, so go ahead, use your EBT, pick it up. If you see it, be a scavenger hunt, y'all. Every time you go out, be like, what is that, you know? And get it. And even if you get one or more, you know, you can get one and separate them and make more. Or if you see a few, get a few, you know? You got a lot of family members, you want to get a lot, okay? But definitely check them out. They will have some amazing stuff. I have seen all kinds of things, from zucchinis to squashes, watermelons, like cucumbers, parsley, oregano. You know, I've seen different stuff out there. You know, I haven't seen anything like fruit trees and stuff like that, but I have seen other things. Again, check it out. pick it up, take it to the register, and charge that to the EBT. Okay, and it will more than likely go through it, okay? Now, if it doesn't, then that store, per se, does not accept EBT, right? Or it doesn't, well, yeah, it just doesn't accept EBT. Because if they accept EBT, then they're going to accept a plant that is edible as considered a food that you can eat. The only thing that they don't allow is hot food, unless you're, you know, here in California, then you can get edible food that you can actually, you know, be able to eat that's hot. But per se, most places, it has to be a cold food. It has to be cold and it cannot be hot. It has to be in a box or whatever. It just can't be hot. So, yes. So we have that for that. I don't want to keep you guys too long on this. But yeah, so that's just me showing you the things that you can regrow and place them in water or seed or transplants that you can get off of your EBT. So, you know, stay tuned for the next video, because the next video I'm going to actually show you me cutting each of these plants and, you know, cutting off the part that we're going to go ahead and place into water, and the rest we just eat. And then the other ones we're going to go ahead and plant it in the soil. So I'll be sure to show you guys all that in the very next video. And so stay tuned, guys. I hope this is helpful for you guys. Anybody that's considering to start growing and ready to start today and feel like I don't have enough money for it, yes, you do. You got enough. You got more than enough. And, you know, there's still so many more plants, but we got a good 20 right here that we can work with. I think we can survive on 20 plants, y'all. Okay. So yes, so be sure to stay tuned for the next video as I show you how to cut these, place them in water, and regrow, and voila! Alright guys, thank you so much, and don't forget to thank me later!